New tonight on 7 News, high-tech crime fighting not only in your neighborhood, but in your living room. The latest neighborhood crime fighting tools, personal computers, and cell phones. 7 News reporter Lane Line has more.
When a neighbor in Tollgate Crossing saw a man taking pictures of school kids, a blast of 150 emails went out.
Some of our email addresses are even work addresses, or it goes to your cell phone, or it goes to, you know, your BlackBerry.
Almost immediately, Judy Van Meter says concerned residents flocked to the school. The man disappeared.
In another case, neighbors became concerned of people knocking on doors claiming to be alarm salesmen.
Judy got back on her computer. Also on her list,
guys left their car unlocked.
Aurora officer Brandon Samuels. Right from his patrol car, he responds that other areas have had similar concerns. Turns out the so-called salesmen were actually burglars.
We've gotten that word out, and they were arrested.
Samuels says social media is the latest tool in neighborhood crime fighting.
We have seen it change a little bit to where community websites are kind of changing and going into Twitter and Facebook, and we're able to build up links and get information disseminated.
Now, on this national night out, police and firefighters connect with communities in person and remind watchful neighbors a text or email later could make all the difference.
And tonight I asked police if they think Neighborhood Watch really works. Officer Brandon Samuels says his proof comes in interviewing suspects after they're arrested. He says in the case of the phony salesman, they told him they went to another neighborhood where they thought they'd be less likely to be turned in. Live in Aurora, Lane Lyon, 7 News.
Clever. Thank you, Lane. Now, many police departments in Colorado now Twitter about what is going on in their city. So just log into your account and click Find People to search for your city.